We begin in Washington, where U.S. senators voted on the constitutionality of the second impeachment trial of former President Donald Trump. Our North America Bureau Chief TJ Manotok joins us now with details. TJ.
Good afternoon, Carmina. Well, about after 4 hours of presenting their case with regards to the question of constitutionality of the impeachment trial of former President Donald Trump, the Senate has voted, and with a majority of 56 to 44, the trial will proceed. Today was the formal start of the second impeachment trial of President Donald J. Trump, historic as well as it is the first time that a former president will be impeached in the Senate. Before the House impeachment managers and Trump's defense team could get to the merits of the case of inciting an insurrection, the defense tried to throw out the case altogether by challenging its constitutionality. House managers presented a well-crafted mini-documentary of mesh videos as it intertwined the timeline of events from Trump's speech on January 9, the march and attack of his violent mob of domestic terrorists, and the developments inside the Capitol as lawmakers and then Vice President Mike Pence were certifying the vote to declare Joe Biden the winner of the 2020 elections. They cited some of the nation's most prominent conservative legal scholars who have said it is constitutional to impeach and try an official even after they have left office. The lead House impeachment manager, Congressman Jimmy Raskin, even got emotional as he recalled the nightmare of January 6th when he and many of his colleagues thought they would die. To sum it up, House impeachment managers insisted that it is constitutional and necessary to hold the president accountable for his impeachable acts, even if it's done in his final days in office. When it was a turn for the defense to attempt to prove that trying a former president was unconstitutional, Trump's defense lawyers were seen by critics as incoherent and ill-prepared. Attorney Castor argued Democrats just want to convict Trump only because they fear he'll run again in 2024. Toward the end of his speech, he conceded, "We changed what we were going to do on account that we thought that the House manager's presentation was well done." Castor's main argument is that the electoral system worked and Democrats got what they wanted, to remove Trump from office as he lost the election to Joe Biden.
With this trial, you will open up new and bigger wounds across the nation, for a great many Americans see this process for exactly what it is: a chance by a group of partisan politicians seeking to eliminate Donald Trump from the American political scene and seeking to disenfranchise 74 million plus American voters and those who dare to share their political beliefs and vision of America.
The Senate proceed with the trial.
You ask what a high crime and misdemeanor is under our Constitution? That's a high crime and misdemeanor. If that's not an impeachable offense, then there is no such thing.
Casey, the trial will resume tomorrow at 12 noon Eastern Standard Time, and the House managers and the defense are both given 16 hours each to present their case. Everybody expects this whole thing to wrap up by Sunday, wherein they could be forcing a vote already, and most likely, analysts are seeing that an acquittal will be looming again for Donald Trump because the numbers just aren't there for now for the Democratic side. Casey?
All right, TJ, just one quick question about the American public. How are they taking to the impeachment trial? Remember, the concern is to push through with the trial would be to open up again the divisiveness in the nation as Joe Biden is just beginning to heal it. So how is the public reacting to this, TJ?
Well, two things you want to gauge here, Casey. You have to see what the Republicans are saying and take that, with context, that they're saying that if this pushes through, it will open up those wounds again. It will force the divide even wider and really put it back on a microscope. And as well, President Joe Biden himself, he's not involved. He's not talking about the impeachment. He knows that if he adds fuel to the fire, this could derail his efforts for unity. So if you look at those things on the sideline outside of the Senate right now, those are very telling in terms of what this impeachment trial can do. But then again, the Democrats are insistent. They can't just let Donald Trump off the hook. He has to be held accountable because it will be setting a precedent that any president could do anything they want in the last weeks of their administration, even if it is impeachable. Carmina.
All right. Our North America Bureau Chief there, TJ Manotok, joining us from San Francisco. Take care, Tej. Thanks for joining us today.